Okay, in this assignment, I will teach you how to load data, transaction data in InfoCube. And we start from where we left in the previous assignment. So I'll log on to SAP, and this time I'm using my login ID LU096. So I get into data warehousing workbench, then I go to data flow, and then from the data flow, I can find out my data flow cells data, and I double click on that. So I come here, and at this point, I will assign the InfoCube. So I will right click. Okay, let me use the change first, and then I will right click. I will use existing object. And let me search for it. So I will search with MU67 star and 096. That's my login ID. You use your login ID. So our InfoCube is GBI reporting, and I get that. And I save my work. After this, what I'm going to do is I'm going to create transformation. In order to create transformation, I would select the transformation arrow, right click, I will say create, and here object type is InfoCube, and source of the transformation is data store object, so everything remains the same, and then I just say create transformation. Okay, at this point I have to do the mapping. So, sales order, let's see, material goes to material, where is my material, here is my material, okay. Make sure that the mapping is as it is here plus some more, okay. I have to connect revenue and discount to net sales. So I have revenue and I have discount connected to net sales, and also the key is connected. Okay. Also I think the calendar day goes to the calendar month. So the calendar day here goes to the calendar month. Okay, now I have to click on the rule for net sales. The rule is formula, rule type. Okay, and now I have to put in the formula. So the formula is backslash revenue. Okay, see, I got two backslashes. I don't need that, so I need to remove that. So I just need the revenue, okay, minus discount. Okay, that's my formula, and after that I go back. My formula is already entered, and at this point I can just transfer the values. Now we will define the transfer good transfer rules for cost of goods sold. So you can see the cost of goods sold here, and however sorry, that's cost of goods manufactured. So I have to connect sales quantity and material to cost of goods manufactured. So material and sales quantity. Okay. And then I have to click on the rule. And in this case, the rule type is routine. That will open the source code for me. Okay. Now, you have to at this point open your assignment 9. Okay. So open your assignment 9 go to page number 15. Okay, here you will see the code and change the code to your own login ID and the proper root. So we are using root 67. So this is root 67 and this is for 003, mine is 096. So I type in 096, you type in your login ID. So again, I'll put in the correct root and then I will put in my login ID, which is 096. You please use your own login ID. Do not use 096. Okay, same thing here, wherever I see 29, I make it 67, and then 003, I change it to my own login ID. So looks like everything is fine. So then I copy, including the period here, and I do Control C. Okay, now after that, I come back to my rules detail, and here, look at this result, remove that, okay, remove that and then type Control V that code. So I Control V that code and after I'm done with it, I check my rule. So I click on check actually before I do that, I have been asked to take a screenshot, okay. So take a screenshot of your code and paste it in your Word document, and after that I click the check icon, okay. So I click the check icon here. So no syntax errors found. So that means I'm good. And then I need to save my code. So I save my code. Okay. Then I put in a description here, which is cost of goods manufactured USD. So cost of goods okay, here in currency, I say no conversion. And I've entered the description. So all I need to do is now transfer values. Okay, so I transfer values now. Now at this point, you need to take a screenshot of your transformation and of your mapping. And you need to paste it in your Word document, then you need to activate the data, the transformation. Okay, after activating, just save it and return to your data flow template. So I return, go back, I return here, and you can see the transformation is active now. Okay, Now I right click on the data transfer process line and then I say create data transfer process. I just have to continue. Here in the extraction tab, I have to make it full. And I have to activate it again. Then I go to the execute tab. I click the execute button. I say yes. Just refresh one time and you see all green. That means it has worked. And then I click on the administer data target icon, which is this one. Click the contents tab. Now to view the data, you have to select either the display InfoCube content button or the display fact table button. So I can click on here. Just let me go back. Okay, now I do the InfoCube content and I execute. I see the data now, or I can go back and I can click on the fact table and I can execute and I can see the data now. Okay. Now I go back. Further. And I come back to the data flow. Double click on that, I come back here. Did I not save it? Let me display it again. Okay, come here, transformation. Since I don't see it, I'm just doing it one more time. Okay, so it's done and I okay, now I see that the process is completed. Sorry about that. Okay, so at this point I right click on my InfoCube and I display data. Okay, then what I do is click on the field selection for output button. Okay, I click select all characteristics button. And then I deselect the following items. change run ID, okay, record type, request ID, and calendar month. And I make sure that all my key figures are selected. Okay, so here are they all of them are selected. So at this point I will click on execute, okay, and then again execute, and now I see my data here, and I have to check the net sales calculation to make sure that it is correct, which is revenue minus discount. So this is my net sales, do you see that? And I have revenue is 20, discount is 6, so my net sale is 14, which is correct. So you can see that my calculation of net sales, which I did by using formula revenue minus discount, is indeed correct. So take a screenshot of your InfoCube data and paste it in your Word document. Now cost of goods manufactured is calculated as sales quantity multiplied by transfer price. Okay, after you took the screenshot, press the back button here and come to info objects, okay, and within info objects come to characteristics, expand on the characteristics, you will see material. So within material, right click and you will see maintain master data. Click on maintain master data, execute, and you will see the maintain master data list from there, and take a screenshot of this and paste it to your Word document. So now you know how to load data, transaction data, into your InfoCube. Save your work. Just in order to see my data flow again, I'm going back, it's not necessary for you. So you can see that you have configured a whole star schema actually. You have the dimension table, you have the fact table, and you have the info cube. You have loaded data from your flat file to info objects. And then you have also loaded the transaction data into your info cube. Thank you.